beautiful girl, wherever you are, I knew when I saw you, you had opened the door. I knew that I'd love again after a long, long while. I'd love again.
You know, they say that it takes a village to raise a child. That's an understatement. It took a village and the universe to raise a child. God has been so good to you, Thessa. He has given you a life that is so precious. He has blessed you with so many talents and wonderful things in life. I know it's not always a smooth ride and sail in the last 18 years, but as young as you are, God has shown you how to tackle life. I praise God that even though life gets tough, He is helping you by refocusing and redirecting your paths according to His ways. We love you so much. More than you'll ever know. When you achieve life, when you're happy, your dad and I doubles that happiness. When you pass the test, when you pass your driving test, that's double the happiness for us. When you hurt, that doubles the hurt for us too. But I just wanted to let you know that it's a blessing and it's an honor to be your mom. We love you so much, Thessa. And my prayer is for you to continue to look up to Jesus and focus on Him. Because He will always be there for you. 18 years is such a young age, but you have accomplished so much. And thank you for always having that smile on your face. Sometimes it's hard, but thank you so much for brightening our days. You're the most loudest, the most expensive, among the other two. The most emotional, the most temperamental daughter. When you were little, Dollar Tree was enough for you. Mama Jean was so happy bringing my kids to Dollar Tree, because they never complained. But now it's, you know, it's a different ballgame, but I really praise the Lord for all these 18 years that He has given me. I love you. Happy birthday.
My Thessa Joyce, look at you. You already have the life. You're already grown up to be a young lady. Your mom and I are truly blessed to have you in our lives. So first your brother JN and your brother Joshua. In the moment when your mom is pregnant, all I could ask for is for our baby to be healthy and one day come to love and serve the Lord of Jesus Christ. All those days while your mom was pregnant with you, I received a call that she was involved in a car accident, that I was worried about your health and your safety. Praying that everything would be okay. On one of the many days during your mom's last trimester, we had a visit with your mom, so it will be sometime late in the morning in September, and that happened to be September 11th. We're hoping and praying that it would be the time that you're supposed to be born. But God had other plans, and you were born on 1810, around 1820 hours that day. The miracle of God's creation has revealed itself the moment I saw you being delivered. What a joy it was to see my new baby girl come into this world. During your first day or two at the hospital, we noticed that you need to stay at the NICU. It saddened me to see your tiny little body lay there with all those wires and other sensors and other things. And a few days later, we brought you home. Your mom and I prayed for you so that you can get better. As you continued to grow, maybe around your second or fourth year, I remember calling 911. As you were sleeping and you weren't responding, and your eyes were kept on fluttering back and forth. Shortly later, and you were sent to one of the hospitals in your body. We all pray that God will continue to protect you and keep you, and whatever His will is and whatever outcome was, all I can do is get on my knees and pray. that you'd be okay. That was the most scariest part of my life. For us waiting in the emergency room to see what the outcome would be. By God's grace, we were stabilized and we took you home later that early morning. Fast forward for many years to come, when we moved here, you've experienced ups and downs, and one of the darkest moments that we've seen, where we've seen God's work in your hand. And not in your life, but also mine. My verse for you is in Psalms 36, verse 4 and 5. Delight thyself also unto the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of thine heart. Commit thy ways unto the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring the to pass. Love you, Thessa, and may God continue to guide your path wherever he leads you, and continue to serve and love him more day by day.
Whenever you are ready, just let it all out.